My name is Dirk Colbury, and I'm going to show you how to run an X11 client so that you can get graphical user interfaces or GUIs working on Windows. For the first step, I will assume you already have PuTTY installed. If you don't, please see my PuTTY tutorial. So I'm going to close PuTTY for now. Open up my web browser. Go to Google and type XMing, which is the name of the X Windows server I'd like you to try, and I'm actually going to type XMing download. So now I get a message at the top that says they're preventing me from downloading this. So let's click here and see what it says. Download file, what's the risk, information help file. Well, I know SourceForge website and I know XMing, so I'm going to be confident that I can download this file. And I'm going to save the file on my desktop for now. Quick and easy. We will just close this, close my web browser, and yep, there's XMing. So let's double click on it. Yes, I know what XMing is, and I think it's safe. We're going to click continue. I'm going to install it in the default directory. And I'm going to do, if you've already installed PuTTY, you don't need to install an SSH client. However, I'm just going to assume you haven't installed PuTTY and you can click normal. It doesn't matter either way, they will still both work. So we'll just hit next. I'm going to install the shortcut in an XMing folder. So now I have choices. I can create a desktop icon, create a desktop icon for XLaunch. I'm just going to just say, leave all those blanks because I don't want to clutter my Windows install. And everything looks good, so I'm going to hit install. Now the trick to knowing if XMing is running is there's going to be a little icon on here, and the first time you run it, it's going to ask you, do you want this program to connect to the internet? Well, we need to connect to the internet to pass the information from the HBCC to this to your computer, so we're going to allow access. And that's it. Now we have X running. Assuming we have X running, or X is not running, we can just select XMing from here, or I can actually go into Programs, XMing, and we'll run XMing. All this should do is put the XMing icon here in the corner. That means the server is running. With the server running, now we need a program to connect to it, which in this case is PuTTY. First thing we need to do is load a configuration. In our case, we're going to load the High Performance Computing Center. Then I can go down here to connect X11 and turn on X11 and forwarding. Now, when I go back to my session, I'm going to save it so that X11 forwarding will be forwarded from now on. And when I hit open, I log in with my username and my password. And now we want to test to see if X11 is working. To do this, we just need to run a program that requires X11, a simple one that's very small. It's called XEyes. And if everything works, we should get a set of eyes that appears on our computer. Now, I don't see my set of eyes, but I see that X is blinking. And my guess is the eyes are actually hidden behind my PuTTY window. So, yep, I click on the X, and there they are. I could have moved the PuTTY window out of the way. And there's the X eyes. And that doesn't do anything except follow your mouse around and look cute. But what what's interesting about this program is it's not running on your local computer. Only the graphics are being shown. The actual program itself is running on Gateway in this case. So at this point, if you wanted to run a real program, we could SSH into one of the dev nodes. Let's do AMD09. And let's run MATLAB. One thing about X11 is it can be very slow. It will work fine on campus, but it tends to be too slow to work off campus. So if you try to use it off campus, you're going to find it takes a lot longer to wait for your windows to come up. But as you can see here, this is my MATLAB, and it's running fine. And it's actually running on AMD 09, not on my local computer. That's it. That's all you need to know to install X11.